Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to Dragon's Dogma, Dark Arisen. We have changed things up quite a bit, so I'm going to go into just a brief overview of what I did in between this video and the previous one. So I am now a warrior. Rank 1. We're all the way back at the beginning. I have a few abilities. I have a giant, freaking awesome, totally sweet, two-handed long sword. Great sword. Great long sword strapped to my back. Otherwise, my armor is more or less the same. We have Savage Lash, Upward Strike, and Pommel Strike. Nothing upgraded because I'm a brand new warrior. The other thing that I have is I've learned the two combo abilities for Great Swords, and we have Bastion now. It was a pretty cool place in Kingdom Hearts, the Hollow Bastion. This reduces the physical damage that we take from physical attacks, physically. So it's pretty cool. That's it for me. Case, I tweaked his abilities slightly, so he has Thunder and Ice as his two, buff abilities. High Blurring still, so that's the blinding things that get close to him ability. But he now has Spell Screen, so I swapped out Haladon for Spell Screen, which was his, like, ultimate final ability. He can have Spell Screen and High Spell Screen. It was expensive as hell with Discipline. He has other, like, augments that I want to buy for him, but I can't afford them yet, so that sucks. But Spell Screen, it's a magical sigil that he, it's around him, it looks like. But it gives a pretty hefty increase to the defenses, like all the different status effect resistances and all your different, like, elemental resistances, all the things. Pretty good. Pretty decent defense bonus. High Spell Screen will give a lot more if and when we can afford that. So that's a bit more utility, like less healy, more utility. So that's cool. We have Daisy, who is a sorcerer. She just got a bunch of attacks. Brontide, Bolide, High Leaven, High Miasma, Grand Ingle, High Frazzle. So just lots of attacks. She's a challenger and utilitarian. And then Lady is a scather, and she is what I just was. She's a fighter, so she's got a sword and shield and a jester hat. Blitzstrike, Broad Slash, Flesh Skewer, blah, 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 all those things. So I opted to go with a fighter instead of a ranger class or a strider class, a thief, the dagger and bow and arrow class. So now there's going to be two of us on the front line protecting my two ranged characters, my two magic users. So we'll see how this goes. It's just for the sake of having something a little different. And so all that said and done, the thing about the giant sword that I have is I only have one set of skills, so I can't use, like, I obviously don't have a shield anymore, so I can't block or use shield skills, but I don't get, like, mages, they two-hand their staves, their staffs, and they get 6 abilities. I only get 3 no matter what. I can't have more than that. So a brief overview of them. Upward Strike, I stabby-stab forward, and then I try to launch it into the air. That's kind of fun. Pommel Strike is just a quick little boop. Try and stun things or knock them over or interrupt what they're doing, get them to, like, drop their shield or something. And then Savage Lash is an interesting one because I charge it. And we just kind of have to stand still and charge it. Do a little crotch thrust action there, and then shabam. And it hurts real bad. And I think if we time it so that we let go the instant that bar fills, like when our character flashes, I think it does, like, critical damage. So it's real, real good if we can land it. I'm also just, like, big and slow and do a lot of damage. So it's going to be a fun change. I have, like, only rarely used this class. I usually play it a little bit to get all the augments and stuff, and then, or at least just get a couple of augments, maybe not even all of them. So this is going to be an interesting change of pace for me. I'm not usually a melee character in these sorts of games.
I'll make her be good. Are you the Arisen, sir? I'm of the party sent to survey the ruins.
Oh, so you're the one that we're sent here to save. I guess we need to go inside and kill things? Does that sound about right? Oh, yes, that sounds about right. That sounds about exactly right. There's, they were running, trying to escape whatever nonsense is in here, and then this guy made it out, turned around, and his buddy wasn't behind him. So we need to go find his friend. That's our mission.
Scholars of the Faith gave the Watergod its name not long ago.
Oh man, my character's attacks are so freakishly slow.
Or so they say. In truth, no one knows for sure who
is. I am gonna dig up a few fish. Fish up a few fish. I'm gonna do that a little bit, because more stamina recovery items are gonna be really, really good for me playing this character. I just destroy everything around me when I swing the sword. It's kind of cool. Mithridate. Oh, good. Poison curative items. That's always a good sign when the game hands you those at the entrance to a new area.
What's that?
Man, I don't remember my way around here at all. I think there's like a bunch of zombies in this room. Or skeletons. Yeah, there they are.
Skeletons!
There's a bunch of herbs and things here that you can grab, so I'll do that too. Haha, vocation up already. That's sweet. Some scrap iron. Oh, I got the defense boost. Oh, so that doesn't last. It just, like, is an explosion around him that boosts our defense. That's gonna be good to know. Hey, this is not a setup that I'm used to using in any sense. So, like, spell screen is a new thing for me.
I shall restore your health. Hold on.
This is gonna be good. It's gonna be good. I can already tell. Paste, hearthspud milk, some clean cloth. Okay. So many things looted. Okay, good. And then this is where we ultimately need to go, but we don't have the key. So we gotta find that. Oh yes, and then we don't have the bridge here.
What, that we could get this lift moving?
It will be easier going searching this area now.
My giant ice sword is so cool looking.
Our server's bait. Strike the tail.
Oh yeah, you're gonna be bait. That's fine. And then I froze it.
Ah,
lovely.
This should change the stakes.
Where's Zach? Oh, the one last thing that I did want to point out. Equipment. There it is. Since I'm no longer the sword and shielder, the sword and shield ring that gave me the blitz strike attack didn't make sense to keep that. So we have cleansing earrings. So I have like really, really high poison resistance now. So how's that for a little bit of preparation before we came in here? Shabam! See, that's the damage thing that I was talking about. Oh, don't knock it out of my way, you idiot. Alright, that'll still be good. So, I think it's...
The tail! Hurry, while I'm a home!
Comestion? It's whatever the other fire ability is. Hey, we killed him, and it magically caused the door to open. Oh, because there's reinforcements. Whatever the really cool fire sorcerer ability is called, our sorcerer friend has it. It causes the meteors to fall from the sky. That's the thing that you just saw happen.
Our server's bait! Strike the table!
We don't even need to chop the tails off. I can just kill these things in like one or two hits. Oh, it's great.
I grant you Arisen's might!
We have triumphed.
This is kind of fun, just being like a giant sword-swinging monster.
I shall restore your health. Hold on.
Cool. Are these waterfall gentian roots?
Poison!
I believe are pretty gosh darn heavy. So I am going to want to offload those to one of my pawns sooner or later. Giant coin pouch. Don't mind getting that. Watergod's altar lever. That'll be very, very important. Cool.
I'll heal your wounds.
Alright, I like how this is going so far. So the lever will go right here. Ta-da! Then we can pull the lever. We can lower the bridge. I don't need to see that. We now have a bridge. Can we go this way? We cannot.
It'll be easier going searching this
area. Yeah, so the ruins are flooded, and part of our goal for all of this stuff is we need to lower the water level here. No case. You can have the other one too. Just hold on to it. I don't need it. And can I tell you to use it? No, but hopefully you will just use it.
I shall restore your health. Hold on.
Also, I do want to point out, if our pawns fall into the brine, they don't respawn on shore like I do. They are just flat out dead. Oh, yeah.
I serve as bait. Strike the tail. I leave the resource to you.
The Saurians have a fun ability.
Hurry while I behold!
We've seen it before. It hasn't really been a threat before, though. They, they're kind of chameleon-y. They can blend in with their surroundings. They turn invisible.
Just wait.
So that's a thing that we need to be aware of. Yeah, there's one up on the wall there. Yeah, you can see him through the light. Oh. Bad thunder attack.
They rampage into scrimmage.
And he's done. Okay. Not having a ranged attack means there's really not anything I can do about those skeleton sorcerers out there. Oh man, I need to like turn off whatever that action cam thing is that is happening, because that's really irritating. Oh, Saurian's gone. Oh, we can get out there.
Now we'll gain the upper hand.
And then I died.
Master, you're back.
Well, let's try that again. I got fireballed out of the air. That's the problem about trying to get out there.
I'll heal your wounds.
Saurian on the water down there. Oh, did they? But they're gone. Have they just not spawned yet? I'm so confused. Are they done? They're done.
Strike as it swims.
Okay. All right. So now to explore this area. There's going to be a lot of exploring for finding items and things, but I want to kill as many of the Saurian jerk faces as we can. Because if we let them like get the drop on me or something, it'll just be irritating. Ooh, golden egg. I have a thing. Yeah. Oof, those are very heavy for not a lot of HP restoration. Oh, but these ones are super light. Huh. We're going to put the golden egg in the airtight flask so it doesn't go bad. I don't remember what, if any, use it might have. And then we're drenched in water, so I'm going to just go ahead and use the clean cloth. So we are no longer drenched in water. Our lantern... Oh, it's out of fuel anyway. So we'll just go ahead and fill it up, and then we'll be fine. If you have the lantern out and you get drenched, the lantern will... that's ultimately where we need to go, by the way, is up there. If you have the lantern out and you get drenched, the lantern will be wet, it'll go out, and you'll have to either unequip it and then re-equip it, which is just obnoxious, or you'll need to, dry yourself off like I did. So this is where I wanted to go earlier. Wanted to do a little bit of mining here. I don't think it's going to be anything good. I think it's just the same old minerals that we've seen already. Silver ore, though. That's not bad. Okay.
Monsters arisen! Ready yourself! I'll serve as bait!
Okay. Nope. We're done with that. That's going away. That's so obnoxious. What is that? On command, status display. On chatter. I might just turn that off too. And you know what? On, you're obnoxious. I'm going to turn you down. Cinematic camera. Yeah. Yeah, that's going away. Save. There we go. All right. That is a lot better. And it's just Saurians. I don't really care about anything that they have. They've just got Saurian tails and scales, and we have plenty of those things. Ah, well. Here's where we need to be. And, looks like we got a friend hanging out back there. I wonder if he's the one responsible for this. I'm gonna say he is. Green Warish, that's cool. Okay, well, you guys can go down there. I'm gonna fight Cyclops. I still don't remember how to lower the water level. It's one of these little side paths. Ooh, and also there's a bunch of stuff in here. Arspud milk, that's actually not fantastic. These are fancy chests, though. Brother the Cap, that's not very good. Light outfit, probably not very good. Ten blast arrows. Eventually I am going to play as like a strider or something, just for a little bit. They have some really useful augments that would be nice to have. Let's get one more of these. And here we go, it's ogre time. So I'm gonna miss. I tried to climb him. I wanna get up under his face. Like maybe he bash his tusks off, like that. Where am I? Camera, what's happening? Oh, I'm on his arm now. Okay. This will be good. Oh, nope. That'll be bad. Here, hang on. We need so much junk here. Yeah, I'll eat the two Saurian tails. I gotta get rid of a bunch of this crap. Because I always have so much junk I need to get rid of. With this thing. Or the crotch. There we go. Oh, it was fantastic. And he dropped a red thing. That's kind of cool. Oh, and that completed one of our quests. That completed our kill lots of these cyclopses in the Water God's altar area. We had a quest for that. Water God's altar key! Hooray! That's the key that we need. I think that'll take us to the area where we lower the water level, finally. Okay, I forget if we can go this way yet, or if the water level thing will be a problem for us down here. Probably will. It almost certainly will. It is. That's fine. We'll be back. So much backtracking in this place. Where was up? There it is. Oh, that was close. I want that chest in there, and I want that bag of money right there. We'll have to remember those and go back for them later. For now, let's go open this door here. Yep, door. Got it. Oh, this is a, that's a different color Saurian. That's a striped Saurian. Have these all been striped Saurians? I don't think so. I think they've all been the regular kind. Striped Saurians are like hobgoblins. Like, they're the next tier up. Saurian tactics. I don't think that'll be useful for any of us. Ooh, sulfur Saurians. Yes, please. Okay, so we learned a little bit about the sulfur Saurians, which is what those striped ones are. What convenient timing. Somebody found a liquid vim? You are not allowed to hold onto those. Also, what's this? Did you use the liquid vim? Oh, lady. Okay, there we go. Ooh. You are not allowed to hold those. Those are for me only. Okay, so fire apparently just wrecks these guys. Are they just not going to leave anything at all behind? Oh man, that makes me sad. I'd love to get like some striped Saurian skins, blah, or scales or something. Okay, that glow effect making it really hard to see the invisible lizard creatures that might be on the walls. Welcome to being a melee character who is on fire. We'll just eat all the green orish. Oh, we had a quest for killing these guys too. That's awesome. We have so many of these quests that we've turned in. I will let somebody else hopefully do that mining. Maybe. Maybe I'll just let my pawns be useless and wander around. Come on. I'm paying you guys to pick up items for me. Do that. Nope. Okay. I guess it's gonna be me. That's fine. I am heavily encumbered. That's no good. Oh, 60 skulls. Oh, because that was our reward for the quest. Some of the quests give you weird things like that. Oh, inventory management. Somebody can have the dumb little hat. Somebody can have the light outfit. I'll actually give that to Casey. It might be better for him. Those are very, very heavy.
Good grief.
Okay. Inventory has been managed to some extent. Aha, this is the water level lower. Blah. It's a button. That does the thing that we wanted it to do. Hooray! You were what I was looking for. I just hadn't realized it. Cool. Now, we can explore the Water God's altar proper. So what is this tied to? Okay, so this is back at the start of the bridge thing. That's fine. Sounded like skeletons. There you are. It'd be so nice if I could actually walk around and charge. This is fine too. Altar slate. So that is presumably the relic that they were here looking for. I think if we go back and tell the guy that his friend is dead, he'll be like, oh no, please. At least get the relic that we're here for. Oh my gosh. Hit it. Oh. So that was a phantasm. Those things are awful. They can only be hurt by magic. Usually I'm totally fine with them because I am usually playing one of the magically inclined characters. But unless I have like an element on my weapon, I'm not gonna be able to hit that thing. And it keeps phasing in and out, you see. So I would love... Okay, I take that back. They possess people like you just saw it do the lady there. You can hit them with physical attacks while they're possessing somebody, and it'll A, knock the ghost off of them and free your friend, and B, it will let you actually do damage to them at the same time. Okay, y'all are getting some fish, that's fine. I'm gonna get another treasure chest here. I forget how many of the tablet pieces there are in here. There are a bunch, and we need to find all of them. Also, oh my gosh, so much armor. Oh, nice. Another altar slate. One of a number of pieces scattered about the sunken ruins, the writing on it must be deciphered. Well, you're gonna hold two of them for me. Because they are heavy as balls and I just can't really be bothered. Oh, dang it. It was a bit less graceful than I wanted it to be. I think that's where we came down. Alright, I'm getting my bearings here. Figuring it out. I think we have to go past Mr. Cyclops on the very precarious bridge. It is a tiny Cyclops! He doesn't get the giant boss health bar, he just has the health bar above his head. He's still a huge threat, though. enough on the knee, it should eventually knock him over. But I think the bigger problem we have right now is just that he's, like, enraged. So he's really tough to hit. Like, he's just going bonkers here. There we go. Problem solved. Just had to make sure he's dead. Don't want any zombies coming back. Oh, that would be awful. Yeah, I'll just leave these things for my pawns to pick up. Hopefully. If they at least get some, that'll be fine. Okay, so there was a left and a right. Left... Oh, and left keeps going. And apparently nothing to mine, so... Oh, I know exactly where we are. This area was flooded earlier. And now we can get down here. Aha! So are you going to be another one of the slates? Yes. So that's three. I'm going to assume that that is all of them. I think that's all of them. We'll just say yes, that's all of them, and get the heck out of here. I don't know where any more of them would be. Unless I'm just, like, going in circles down there and completely missing a very obvious area. Which has been known to happen. But I think we're fine. So... Oh, what was this way? We never went down here. I think this just leads to a very short dead end. Yeah. So you can see the water pouring down into the little, like, lake area. Cool. So I don't think we need our lantern anymore. Put it away now to conserve oil. And let's go get rid of all this heavy crap that we're carrying around. Look at these fancy chunks of rock. Alright, you. Your friend is dead, but we have these fancy rocks. Is that a fair trade?
Jean? Dead? I see. Please, that he...
We'll need to explore the ruins anew to learn more.
Oh man, how many of these tablets do we need? Five. I was afraid of that. But... Oh. Hopefully. They will be marked on the map now. Let's go see if we can find those last two that we're missing real quick. Yeah, they are marked on the map. Oh, that's great. Or at least something is marked on the map. Oh, rough areas. Okay, that's fine. I'm totally okay with that. Oh, and the rats have respawned. I'm hoping that doesn't mean that everything has respawned. Doesn't look like it all has. That's good. So there's one... just, like, to the left of us here. Oh, let's get the, lantern back on. I kind of forgot about that. Oh, it's up. Oh, I see. Here, there it is. Oh man, it's got like a bunch of little glowy bits on the ground behind it. Kill you, grab your scrag of beast, grab all these things, little like curatives and whatnot. And cloth. Pretty cool. I'm massively encumbered, though. who wants to carry two of these? And the last one's just up here to the left, so I did just completely miss it. Aha! There it is! Okay, that was really easy. Okay. Yay! That was all we needed. So let's run right back outside and turn this in. And that is the first of our four worm hunt quests to do. So the Duke has requested, or he's given us permission to join the worm hunt, which is like their fancy way of saying, well, the dragon is scary and we need to deal with it, but we also need to deal with all this other crap too. So how about we deal with all this other crap to prepare ourselves before we fight the dragon? Yeah, yeah, that's it. That's basically what we're doing. So this will be the first one more or less done. Then we have three more to do.
Such as these often house engraved slates and other.
Okay, don't care. Here, have all five. Yay, that's all of them. Great, you should take them back to town.
You have my thanks, Arisen. I shall break the sad news of Brother Jean's sacrifice to Father Geoffrey myself. It was no fault of yours, sir. You've done your duty by us well, as the Father shall hear. Pray, do not let it weigh upon your heart. Go and tell Sir Maximilian of our success.
Yay! Cool, so now we just gotta go report back to Sir Maximilian, and we are officially done with the first of our four worm hunt quests. What is this? Moonglow. I'll take it. I need to do inventory management off camera. I'm gonna just jump back to Cassardus and do that real quick. Oh, you know what? We probably also need to do skill management. I might be able to learn a few new things since I leveled up once. That's fine, though. I will, we'll do that later. It's not going to be anything, like, super critical or urgent. I guarantee it. So, we come back here. What do we have on here? Escort Benita to Cape Pact Forge. I have no idea where that is. I have no idea where that is. And then escort Kina to the Prayer Falls. I do actually want to do that one, so I think we'll do that escort quest next time. And whatever, like, killing of dragons or chimeras or, you know, whatever unfortunate events just seem to pop up while we're doing that. But, yeah, that's it for this episode. Thank you for joining me, and may the grace of the Twilight Dragon be with you.